Study after study in recent years, even prior to COVID, by the way, has shown us that if you live in a Republican-controlled state, your life expectancy is, on average, 2 years less than if you lived in a Democratic-controlled state. So people living in blue states live longer on average than those in red states. And it's not just a function of geography. It is, in fact, due to the policies of these Republicans in leadership in these states. And I don't think there has been a better example, other than COVID, of course, of this discrepancy between Republican leadership versus Democratic leadership at the state level than the Flint, Michigan water crisis. There's a brand new book that came out this past week. It is called We the Poisoned, Exposing the Flint Water Crisis Coverup and the Poisoning of 100,000 Americans. It's by our good friend Jordan Cheran with Status Quo News. You have seen me interview him countless times here on Ring of Fire. We've had him on America's Lawyer. He has been the best reporter, absolutely, about the Flint water crisis. And now he has a new book out, which, by the way, I encourage everybody, pick up a copy of this. It is amazing. He sent me a galley of it a little bit ago. I love it, and that's why I'm talking about it here. Because in this book, he reveals details that were not previously known, and even though there are plenty of Democrats involved who screwed up as well, it all flows back to the top. The guy that was in charge, that helped make these decisions, and of course launched the cover-up, was none other than Michigan's Republican governor at the time, Rick Snyder. And Cheran makes it clear in the book that Snyder knew that people were being poisoned. He knew that there was lead poisoning. He knew that there was Legionnaires outbreaks. And he knew it was because in 2014, they switched the water to the Flint River. They knew the pipes couldn't handle it and were leaching lead into this contaminated water. And Snyder didn't tell anyone. And as a result, at least 12 people died. Now, 12 people is the official number from the state. And as Cheran points out in the new book, obviously that number is much higher because there's lots of things they're not taking into account. Let me read you this. This is from an interview Cheran did with the Detroit Metro Times. I believe the book outlines very meticulously a pretty sinister conspiracy between public officials, Wall Street banks, and the state government. I believe it really reveals in a timeline format the biggest cover-up this century. I don't mean to be dramatic. I don't know anything else that has killed so many people. It's unknowable how many people died from this because it has caused so many different health problems, from kidney and liver failure to cancer, which is surging right now in Flint. Legionnaires' deaths could be in the hundreds. And of course, Cheran knows what he's talking about because he has made nearly 24 trips to Flint, Michigan over the last 10 years talking to people. And he goes back and he'll talk to the same people and he sees the health problems they have developed, if they're still alive. And this is something that Cheran and I have talked about in the times that I've interviewed him. But the book goes even deeper than that, folks. It actually has a testimony that was not previously released of Rick Snyder, again, the Republican governor of Michigan at the time, contradicting himself, what he was saying publicly. It's a horrific story. And as I mentioned, right, it's not just the Republicans on this particular issue. You had Democrat Attorney General Dana Nessel, who basically came in and screwed things up so bad that it borders on intentional. And all the charges against all the officials, including Rick Snyder, went away. Nobody was held accountable. But I cannot stress to you enough that this entire crisis could have been avoided if that Republican governor had simply told the people of Flint, listen, don't drink the water. We'll get it situated. I'm declaring a state of emergency right now. We got some bad health news. Go get yourself tested. We'll cover the costs. Don't drink the water. That could have solved it. But in typical Republican fashion, he covered it up because he didn't want it to hurt him politically. We have seen that story play itself out far too many times in this country. We saw it with COVID. We saw it in the red states with COVID. Those governors who said, no masks, no shutdowns, no nothing. They knew how deadly it was, but they couldn't risk the political fallout. It's the same thing with Rick Snyder. So again, I'm going to plug the book one more time because it's phenomenal. We the Poisoned, Exposing the Flint Water Crisis Coverup and the Poisoning of 100,000 Americans. Jordan Cheran. He's with Status Quo News on YouTube. It's a wonderful book. Check it out. And you will be just as shocked as I am by the information inside of it. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.